I am not a math guy. If you've watched this channel long enough, you've probably heard me say that about a million times, but it's true. Not a math guy. Hate math. Back in college, I was one of those English kids who hang out in the oak grove and write stories. Meanwhile, the math and science students were, like, studying. We never studied, the English kids. We just kind of... We just wrote stuff. Drew on the sidewalks sometimes. Anyway, the point is, I'm literally not a math guy. That is completely true. Which could be part of the reason I found this to be the single most confusing goddamn game on the Nintendo DS. Or, you know, it actually is the single most confusing goddamn video game on the Nintendo DS. So it's called Challenge Me, Math Workout. I say the first part's true, it's certainly gonna challenge you, much in the same way finding an alien artifact, and then being caught with it by the rebel aliens, and having them ask you questions about it telepathically with a death ray pointed at your face, would challenge you. Like, you know they want answers, but you don't even know what they're saying. That's Challenge Me, Math Workout. Actually, the rebels shouldn't even have death rays, they should have alien flamethrowers, so none of this makes sense! I mean, honestly, I don't even, like, I'm not even sure, seriously, how to describe what this even is. Like, this is one of the most confusing, overly complicated, obtuse, well, how's that for a math word, obtuse, video games that I've ever played. Seriously, I don't even know really what I'm looking at fully, or what to say about it. I mean, on the one hand, you know, it's one of those casual edutainment minigame games. Think Brain Age, Big Brain Academy, all those Touch Generations type games that made the Nintendo DS one of the biggest, most successful systems ever. Ostensibly, this is one of those. Only if, like, the rebel aliens made one. Their eyes are sewn shut. So you can imagine what their minigames are like. So, yeah, it's basically two minigames. And I say basically because there are actually a couple ways to play each of them, so it feels like more than two, even if it's not. And if you're already confused, don't worry, just wait, because all we've done is talk about how many there are. Just wait till we get to what they actually are. Which, actually, let's do that right now. Let's get to what they are. One is called Formulate, the other is called Hidden Logic. So yeah, even the names are confusing and don't really describe what the games are at all. Hey, great start, rebel aliens. Why don't you just burn me and get it over with? Yeah, this is Formulate. Oh boy, oh boy. Alright, you know what? Let's just do this step by step. Step one, you get a couple cards. Step two, those cards have numbers and math operations on them. Step three, your mind already starts wandering. Knock it off! The Emma Watson movie will still be there when you're done. Step four, you arrange those numbers in such a way that makes sense mathematically. Like, so that the operation has the right answer. Okay, so that's... That's about as clearly as I can explain it. And I guess that sounds pretty clear. Only the interface and the rules are completely f***ing baffling. So you're playing against the computer opponent, so you're taking turns. But also, your numbers have to add up to the number that they have at the top of the screen. Like the last one or something. Seriously, look, I'm not gonna lie. I barely figured out how to even play. It is so unclear and confusing. And, like, for a game aimed at the casual crowd, like the Brain Age people, like, Brain Age at least tells you what to do. Math Workout tells you to go f*** yourself. Numerically. And then there's Hidden Logic, which is also appropriately named, actually, because the logic behind it is totally hidden. Like, whatever. I don't care. I don't even know how to explain it. You have to guess the numbers on the flipped cards, the ones that are flipped over. And all you know is that the cards, they go in ascending order. But that's not even entirely true, because sometimes the numbers can be the same from card to card. Because since there's actually two separate colors of cards, and the numbers are ascending individually by color, or they're... Look, whatever. It's impossible to explain. It's not even explicable. It's literally inexplicable. Which probably isn't the best thing for a video game to be. Then again, don't worry, because the computer wins without you ever even getting a turn. Seriously, look at this. This is... You know, that's not ascending. That's condescending. And guess what, guys? Hope you like one of those games, because that's all there is! That's right, it's a game about math, which is supposed to have limitless possibilities, or whatever crap Neil deGrasse Tyson tells you, and it couldn't be less limitless. The only thing that's limitless here is how dumb it's gonna make you feel. And you know what, guys? You shouldn't feel dumb. Because I refuse to believe anyone knows how to play this. That's my theory. Besides, math is just a theory. Actually, that was a dumb thing to say. But I only arrived at that because I was playing this, and now I feel dumb. But it's still not as dumb as this interface, and this music, and these minigames. It's so dumb. It's Challenge Me Math Workout for the Nintendo DS. Whatever. I didn't even want to turn at this point. I'm just gonna go cry.